let's talk about Muay Thai. Have people fought like that on the street ever? No. How do people fight on the street? That's how people fight on the street. But something cool about Muay Thai. Here's the thing. Muay Thai's advantage, the clinch, and you learn how to fight in the clinch. That's a good. But the disadvantage of Muay Thai, there's not a lot of fluidity. You know, you don't see that. Instead, you look at these tight, stiff movements. So let's say there's two people fighting a Muay Thai fighter. This is how he's going to get taken down. Unlike boxing, look at boxers with their stances and their movement. So Muay Thai's good, but it's impossible to use Muay Thai to fight against more than one person. Because the stepping, the movements, it's not meant for situations like that. So remember, very good to use Muay Thai in the clinch, but not a lot of movement, so multiple attackers will destroy a Muay Thai fighter. Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Okay, let's talk about Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I love Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. People will want to kick you on the ground. They're not going to just try to get into your guard. So what if he picks up a hammer, starts hammering your head? So on the ground, you have to wait for him to come. But what if he doesn't come? So let's pretend you're taken to the ground. So I pass the guard. Boom, I get the armbar. But it's dependent on, I take him to the ground, and he doesn't know much Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu in response. Look, it's helpful, and it's very practical, but still not that practical. It's too limited. He has to be on the ground. It has to be on the ground. Well, let's say, watch this. What if I'm on the ground, he doesn't come? So let's say he knows Jiu-Jitsu, and he's on the ground. What if, okay, I just want to kick him. What if I'm like, okay, I'm not going to fight. I just spit on him. Pull down my pants, I pee on him. Why not? See, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu has problems. And look, what if you have two people fighting you? Are you going to pull guard on two people? You see? It doesn't matter if you're a world champion. You're not going to fight Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu with two people. Look, just die if you want to fight multiple people with Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. This is not a competition. It's a street fight. People want to stomp you. People want to kick you. So Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is not good for self-defense. I'm going to qualify what he says about Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu a lot. I think any Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu dojo will teach you how to get back on your feet. You know, the technical stand-up's one of the first things you learn. How do you get back on your feet and get away? That's one of the first things you learn. Different ways. Someone throws a punch. How do you get away from them, etc. So I think he's trying to be funny, but he's making this assumption that everyone's going to, you know, be on the ground with their foot up in the air, and that's the default. No, the default, especially if you're in a multiple attacker situation, is to fucking get the hell out of there. I think every Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu place that has any kind of seriousness is going to tell you, if there's multiple people, how do you run away? How do you prevent yourself from getting grabbed and taken to the ground, and how do you get away? And on top of that, it's not impossible to grapple with more than one person. It's hard, but I've seen many examples. I'll show you some very brief clips that I've seen online. So check out this clip of Hiron Gracie going up against three people. So look at that. This guy's trying to get him in a triangle. One guy's trying to control his body. One guy's trying to control his legs. So again, this is, look at this, a guillotine attempt on Hiron. So look, this is not like a street situation because there's no strikes going on, right? It's just three people grappling against one person. But still, you're seeing that it is possible, at least grappling, to get go against three people. So we need to test this out, maybe with slaps or something like EBI or something like that. So this is from our friends at Team Fighting Championship. They give us permission to use this footage, but this is a two-on-two fight that got really tangled. Again, jiu-jitsu would have really benefited the people on the bottom. Those are the British getting destroyed by the Latvians. If they knew more jiu-jitsu, they could have untangled themselves. And look at Kavalda. This guy right here, Nikita, look at him doing the armbar on the British guy. Again, if the two British people on the bottom knew jiu-jitsu, they would have done much better in this tanglement. And so this is another angle of the fight. So this was the first takedown. Slavianin, also known as Juris, is taking down one of the signs. And now, so the fight becomes a two-on-two. And again, lots of jiu-jitsu and lots of opportunities for jiu-jitsu. So again, this is multi-person fight that could have gone better for the British people if they knew some more jiu-jitsu. Because right now, they're both on the bottom. They don't really know what to do. They can't reverse the position. And they're getting pounded, absolutely pounded by, look at that, the one guy you saw earlier, the armbar took him down. And this guy right now, now it's 1-on-1 situations. This doesn't really apply to our discussion. He's trying to frame, and then he's trying to get the knee shield in. And then now, look at that. Boom, right? So this illustrates kind of the danger of jiu-jitsu because he's grappling with some guy, and he just literally got kicked in the back as he's grappling. So this is another situation where jiu-jitsu could have really helped him because he's getting held down and kicked in the body and the face, but he doesn't know how to get out of this, right? If he knew some jiu-jitsu, swinging your legs isn't going to do anything. How do you establish something? Yes, you're getting kicked in the face, but try to use some jiu-jitsu to get the other guy on your back off you. So this is a situation that jiu-jitsu could have absolutely benefited him. So when Sri Xiaodong saying something like jiu-jitsu can't fight against multiple opponents, well, yeah, but if you had jiu-jitsu, you'd spare yourself a pounding potentially than what this guy is going through right now because he doesn't know much jiu-jitsu. Just some qualifications, some thoughts, because Sri Xiaodong's being funny, but at the end of the day, he's trying to generate discussion, which is awesome, and this channel is just trying to give him some talking points. Well, let's not talk about Taekwondo. It could be effective, but then it's for kids. Ugh. Ultimately in life, my opinion is you don't want to take an extreme on anything. You don't want to say, oh yeah, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu can never work against multiple opponents, or Kung Fu can never work on the street, or MMA is the best thing ever, right? You have to set maybe little pillars of different views and then examine, and you probably will find that it's more nuanced, it's more middle ground than what you think. So mixed martial arts is awesome, and in fact, the whole definition of mixed martial arts is you take everything that works and you incorporate it in. I do enjoy that Sri Xiaodong's generating a lot of discussion, and I do enjoy all the discussion that I see on this channel from all of you. And I just hope we all learn, keep learning, keep being safe, and keep teaching what works. That's what I've always wanted to do on this channel. That's why I created this channel. And I thank all of you guys for your continued support. Please leave your comments below. Let me know what you think. Let me know what other clips you want me to translate if it's Chinese. Again, I have this ability to be bilingual, so it's rare, especially in the martial arts community. So give me clips that are Chinese that you want to translate. And again, some of you have been sending me clips. It's not that I don't want to translate them. It's just sometimes those clips don't have much substance, so I don't want to waste my time and waste your time. But anyways, keep up the good work. Join our Discord if you haven't yet. My Discord's mostly my other channel, and a few of you do go on there to talk about MMA, fights, etc. But I want more of you on my Discord. So join my Discord. And also, go and subscribe to Cobrini at BJJ's channel. Very good channel. Bye-bye.